Okay, I am doing a user experience of a couple of games that some students at Full Sail University created. I'm going to do Team Kukuru. Hopefully, this is the correct version of the game. Name of the game is Undead Pandemonium. I'm actually curious because this was one of the games that I was originally working on in the class. But I was told that online students need to play with online students and campus students need to play with campus students. So I'm actually curious what how this game has progressed, and hopefully this is the correct build. Okay, it looks like there's a full option screen. Not sure if that really matters. View distance. Okay. Not sure if that's actually going to change anything. Debug level. What's in here? Guy's here. Okay, that's the controls. R reloads. E to interact, but it's not interacting with anything. Huh, that's cool. So you have an aim button. Character looks pretty cool. I can jump and shoot relatively quick. Miv. Probably would have used the crosshair instead of a random square for actual crosshair. I don't know how to say it. Okay, I'm assuming there's no enemies in here. R is reload, but there's no indication on the controls here that R is actually reload. Quit. I'm sure you want to quit. Yes. Let's do start. Four levels. Let's start from the top. At Jason's level, survive as long as possible. Okay. Don't know if that's ammo or reload. 200 bullets. That's maybe points. It's telling me what it is up there. I can't see because it's doing that. That is. Yeah. I can't tell what I'm picking up. Doesn't look like it's bullets because my gun is almost empty. That's the zombies spawn from out of there. I think I need to run to a different area. Run out of ammo. No sprint or anything. I don't know what picking those up is doing. Let me go upstairs. There's a room here. That ammo? Okay, that's not ammo either. Gonna run out of bullets. Doesn't seem like there's any ammo or anything. Round three. I don't see any zombies now. Number of enemies, just one. So there's one enemy somewhere stuck. Let me see if I can go in here. Okay, maybe this is ammo. Yay, ammo! Not that much, considering how much enemy, how spongy the enemies are. Can I go in here? I promise now. Go in here. Don't go there, you go. Grab the ammo again. I'm just gonna send this on the wall. A bit clipping, yeah. That's okay. Let me see if I can find this last zombie. Wherever he is, he's running around. He's somewhere. Where is he? Maybe I should have went in there instead. Now I don't have any points. Not sure where the last zombie is. He's somewhere. Maybe going upstairs, I glitched him and he didn't spawn in the right location. The enemies are kind of spongy. I mean, they didn't kill me, but the enemies seem kind of spongy. And there's really no real ammo for you. It's like, okay, the enemies are spongy and then there's no ammo. Alright, let's try a different stage. Also, there's no apparently background music also. Let's quit. I'm sure. Start. Let's try Logan's level. Survive as long as possible. I'm gonna go here. No. I'm assuming again that's the enemy spawner, so I can't go there. Where's the zombies? Not sure what these collisions are, what these spirits are. Probably can hide that with clicking. I think I wish I knew what I was picking up. What kind of helped me? Oh, and that one died with one hit. Maybe they got hit shots, maybe? I'm picking up something, but I have no idea what it is. It's not ammo. That's a spawner location. That's a spawner. Maybe there's something over here. Nope. That's not where I came from. Almost like you gotta reload your gun every time after you kill something. Enemies, one. Okay, that's cool. The enemies are spawned up. I don't know what that is. Is that something special? Looks cool. Two enemies. I don't know what that does. It's just kind of hovering there. And again, I don't know what the pickups are for these. It said something, but it's kind of sneaky. I don't see any gateways to go through. This is an enemy spawn. There's one enemy spawn somewhere. And I don't know where he is. Yep, here he is. Now there's zero enemy spawn. Round five. Is that a checkpoint? I haven't died yet, which is weird. Pick that up? No? Okay. Doesn't want to pick that one up. No more enemies? Do I shoot them? See you. Aim. One enemy. I think I'm gonna run out of ammo again. Okay, enemy hit. Kind of strong too. Looks like two hits, you're dead. More stuff that I can't pick up. Okay, let's see what happens when you die, especially since I'm out of ammo too. Maybe that's like a checkpoint at 1,770 points. Okay, let me pick that up, but still didn't change my ammo count or anything. More enemies. Now I want to die and I can't. Oh, here comes somebody. Okay. Smacked me. My points, 1380. Retry. No, that didn't do anything. Okay. Interesting again, no music. Ammo super scarce on this section, and enemies can kill you with three hits. Maybe make the enemies a little bit weaker if you want somebody to actually play and maybe have a progression, like a level up system or something like that. Maybe there's some other stages. Start. Alvin stage. Let's see. Survive as long as possible. Okay. So like second player here for me. Like a two-player mode. The design for the characters look really cool. Different gun. Maybe this is like a template for a two-player mode. That actually would make sense. Maybe they have to still work on coding it. Or maybe I download the wrong version. Oh, I didn't know that. You do have a sprint. Yeah, this looks like a work in progress level. You do have a sprint. You have a sprint and they use a stam. Interesting. I guess it does say sprint right there on the side. Okay, there's not much to this stage besides, I guess, maybe a two-player mode if I had somebody else here to play with. That's interesting. I think that's the first time I've seen somebody do a two-player mode on a game. Is there any other stages? Oh, there's a temple. Ooh, there's a dark temple. Cool shadow there. Okay. They're like super aggressive on this level. Just spawn super quick, don't even give you no time to do anything. Okay, what are we going here? Ooh. Use T to alter the time. Oh, okay, so that's like a time freeze. Okay, that's pretty cool. That up. I know that overlay needs to go because you can't see what is getting picked up. Now, are those zombies going to just run through there or am I getting points for them to die? I guess that's what the red adrenaline not available. Okay, can I not pick that up to get new more adrenaline? Okay, that's adrenaline being picked up. So the enemies are dying there, which is kind of weird. So use the adrenaline. Oh, and that didn't work. Okay, that was interesting. I didn't know that he had like an adrenaline system and keys. Okay, so apparently there's keys also that you're supposed to collect. Goodness gracious. They are like immediately. See, adrenaline. Thank you. pretty cool. It's like bullet time. Run. Oh gosh, I got swarmed. Okay, overall interesting game. I kind of wish it had music in the background, something to kind of upbeat with the fighting. The speed slowdown thing was really cool. I wish that was kind of explained earlier, that you can do a time slowdown thing. Ammo super scarce. I only saw like a few ammo reload stations on the stage, which means you got to make every shot count. And I'm not sure how like Call of Duty or something like that, because I'm assuming that's supposed to be kind of based loosely off of a Call of Duty game, but just in a third person perspective. Overall, interesting take, and I do like some of the design work in the stages. And that's it. Thank you. Have a nice day. Oh, I guess I can look and see if the credits are here. They used Unreal Engine 3. Only three people made the game. It's pretty good, though, for three people. I don't think the debug, didn't do anything. I can do time, adrenaline activated. What's going on? Infinite adrenaline here. Okay. Just wanted to mess around now, since I know that there was a like weird adrenaline mechanic in the game.